Ingabi sa tanan, mga igsoon ko ni Kristo, nakapalista na ba mo dito? Palihog daw ang sa atubangan. Bakanti pa itong atubangan. Anisa mo sa atubangan, palihog? Alam, mahadlok sila kanhi sa atubangan. Napay bakante di ani o sa atubangan. Palihog. Kaning bagong nag-abot, ato ipalingkod rin sa atubangan. Salamat. Karon ato ng sugdan, pinaagi sa atong opening song. O Come, Divine Messiah. Palihog manindog ang tanan. Sa ngalan sa Amahan, sa Anak, sa Espiritu Santo. Amen.
Together, O loving God, you remind us that living in faith is a special gift. Increase our faith in you during this holy season so that we may open ourselves to the mystery of your love in our lives. We ask this in the name of Jesus, who lives and reigns with you and of the Holy Spirit forever. Amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated.
Year of Faith 2014. Year of the Lady 2014. Year of the Poor 2015. Year of the Eucharist and the Family 2016. Year of the the parish as a communion of communities, 2017. Year of the clergy and religious, 2018. Year of the youth, 2019. Year of the ecumenism and interreligious dialogue, 2020. And this year, 2021.
Kita ang mga Katoliko magandang kuban sa mga salamatan o nalipalang ng mga kasing-kasing sa pag-aabot sa March 16, 2021, ang ikalimang siglo sa pag-abot sa Kristyanismo ng Ika Natin. Atong pagdudumoy ng banal ang papasalamat sa unang misa dito sa Isla sa Limasawa, ang pagbunyag kang raha humabon kaniadtong 1521, ang pag-abot sa Santo Niño dito sa Cebu, ug ang uban pa. Kita usab sa Archdioceses nangandam og nagkalain-laing programa isip atong pamaagi sa paghanigon ug papasalamat nining tuig tinuyo sa atong simbahan sa Pilipinas o ang Year of Great Jubilee for the Church in the Philippines. Aron maandam ang mga matuunan nining tuiga, ang Year of the Missio ad Gentes o Year of Mission in banan sa tema Gifted to Give. Ug ang Archdioceses sa Cagayan de Oro pagkasaugmugon kini tuiga uban ang tema ACDO on Mission Walking Together. Tara, let's walk together in this year of mission.
Karon ato isunod si Father Kili, ang atong parish priest, alang sa iyang pagpaila sa atong speaker.
Mayong gabi, ganatong tanan. Kumusta naman mo? Amen. Tonight, this task of introducing our guest speaker is a great privilege. I know this one is difficult, but the thought that he is a man of virtue and simplicity, I feel elated to introduce him to everyone tonight. He is a living inspiration to the church. Now, before we present our guest speaker, let us start with the basics. He was born in Nabunglong in 1957. Well, that makes him, you do the computation. When he was 32, he was ordained to the priesthood. But you all need to know that before he became a priest, he was once a student of chemical engineering from CIT and graduated with that degree. So kung gusto ninyo mabal-an unsa ang sodium chloride, pagkata na si Bishya, mga itong speaker karun. Among the archbishops, he is the first to graduate with masters in pastoral ministry from St. John Vianney in CDO. And he also has a licentiate in sacred theology. Many of you knew him as a deputy parish cathedral in the 1990s. And if you are from Camiguin, he also served there in Katarman at St. John Vianney. He served as dean of studies and also taught until 2007. And he was once a parish priest of Medalla Milagrosa Parish before he was sent to the diocese of Malaybalay to become their bishop in 2010. And during the heights of the pandemic, COVID-19, Pope Francis named Archbishop as the new Archbishop of Cagayan de Oro. So wala na may lain yun ng ato Archbishop diri sa atong sa Cagayan de Oro. Many of us will witness his installation in August 28, 2012, online. So, to make the story short, let me introduce our guest speaker for tonight, no other than Archbishop Most Reverend Jose Araneta Cabantan, D.D.
Kayong PE sa tanan. Nagkang kayong salamat for their kini sa pag-research sa internet. In 1989, I was a deacon here sa RER with Father, the late Father Pimentel. So, second half sa 1989 to 1990, we were graduating sa UNA. And unang nakatabang ni Kutali sa una. And also during the time of Father Alfie Villaliba, who was assigned at San Jose Seminary, there are some days magkabang po sa Yaha. Sa high 11 o'clock na mass. Init pa kayo rin, no? 11 o'clock, idilip mo niyo mong glass po man to. So, that's my connection, that is RE. I would like to begin our recollection tonight, in this year of mission, with the readings from the letter of Paul to the Philippians. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. If I may advise you in the name of Christ, and if you can hear it as the voice of love, if we share the same spirit and are capable of mercy and compassion, then I beg of you, make me very happy. Have one love, one spirit, one feeling. Do nothing through life rivalry or vain conceit. On the contrary, let each of you gently consider the others as more important than yourselves. Do not seek your own interest, but rather that of others. Let what was seen in Christ Jesus be seen in you, his servant mine. Though being divine in nature, he did not claim in fact equality with God, but emptied himself, taking on the nature of a servant, made in human likeness, and in his appearance found as a man, he humbled himself by being obedient to death, death on the cross. That is why God exalted him and gave him the name which outshines all names, so that at the name of Jesus all knees should bend in heaven, on earth, and among the dead, and all tongues proclaim that Christ Jesus is the Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Loving God, we ask you to send your Holy Spirit among us, to create the desire to be in communion with you always, especially as we are preparing for the celebration of the feast of the incarnation of our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son. We ask this through Christ our Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So first I would like to say sorry. Father Katie and Sister Byrne asked me if I have a PowerPoint presentation. Sorry, I have not prepared a PowerPoint presentation. I hope that these points will have power, or these points can empower you, depending on the inspiration of the Holy Spirit. Yes, in this year of mission and at the season of Christmas, let us take the Feast of the Incarnation as the paradigm of mission. The paradigm of mission. And we take this reading from the letter of Paul to the Philippians, because what we read in our opening prayer is already a summary from Paul, from the Pauline literature, the summary of the life of Jesus. So Philippians 2, chapter 2, verses 6 to 11, summarizes the life and ministry of Jesus. So, but first, we have to level our understanding with regards to mission. When we talk about mission, it means literally to be sent, to padala. Sini mission impactful, to padala. Ato mga military during the Marawi siege, to padala sa Marawi. Mission nila sa Marawi. So literally, the word mission means to be sent. But it's good also to, from the point of view sa our sa simbahan, we talk about mission before, our understanding are those missionaries, priests, religious, sisters who are sent on a mission at a certain place to evangelize, to Christianize, to baptize. And usually our understanding also of mission before means you are sent on to the foreign nations, foreign countries. Just like us before, when time, in the 1970s, I think most of the priests here are still the Columban fathers, Irish, Australian. The Father Chapman there is a cathedral. Monsignor Cronin is one of the Columban missionaries. Before them, the Jesuits. So these are the missionaries who came to our lands to preach the good news, to evangelize, and to also make us disciples of Christ. So that is our understanding of mission. But as we said today about mission, it does not just refer to priests, bishops, religious, sisters, but all of us are called to be missionaries, lay people. By virtue of our baptism, we are called on a mission. That means that to proclaim the good news in word and in deed is a mission for all of us. Wherever you are, whether you are in the family, whether you are in your office, you are on mission. So, not necessarily, na ipadala ko pa dito sa laing nasod, sa Africa, sa China, to become a missionary. Wherever we are on mission. So that is mission. So, the doon ay mission nga dito sa laing nga nasod, apan doon ay mission, asa ka na mission. Second shift atong sigutan about mission is that understanding of mission is that this mission is really a mission from God. So, hayang atong mission, magtuo mission sa simbahan. So, So we are happy that our brothers and sisters come to church, serves in the church. But more than that, we are most happy that after the celebration of the Eucharist, di ba? Ang palibingon, tapos na misa, panglakaw ka mo, isang yaong ayong balita. So our mission does not end here in the church. We gather here in the church, but our mission is done in our outside, in the field where we are sent. So, hindi lang di ay di mission sa simbahan, kundi di mission sa Ginoo. In sumabot pa sabot, na ang mission sa simbahan is only a participation of the mission of the mission of God. The church is called by the Lord or entrusted by the Lord to proclaim the good news of salvation. Go and proclaim the good news. We are entrusted by this mission. We participate in the mission of God. So, this mission is much broader than we talk about mission of the church. Proclaiming the good news everywhere. Wherever we are, it's much broader than our, when we talk about mission in the church, missio ecclesia. So it's a mission of God. And then another thing that we have to understand before when we talk about mission, 500 years of Christianity. During that time, ang pag-proclaim sa good news is also coupled with power, conquest, to conquer the people. If you can conquer the people, then it's also easy to baptize them, to evangelize them. So it's go hand in hand. It goes hand in hand with a power to conquest, to conquer. So kailangan itong understanding sa mission. Bisang gani sa atong apologetics usahay, apologetics, makakita kita, makadugo kita o mission dia sa plaza, sa divisoria kanya ato, dibo kayo ang debate na, no? Debate. Yun na, makadaog ko, daogon, no? Ustahay pa. Bihagay, no? Bihagay na tawag na sa una, debate, bihagay. Mapildi ka, mahimok ka ang katoliko. Conquer. That's also another understanding of mission. But atong tanahaw karon kana ba gyud ang atong pagsabot sa mission. So as we said from the scriptures, we talk about mission ni sa Ginoo. Mission sa Ginoo. So in John 3:16 for instance, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. He sent his only begotten son. So this that mission. Mission coming from the Father, commissioning the Son to be with us, especially in the season of Christmas, to become incarnate, to be with us, to be among us. Mission. That is why in the same Gospel, the Gospel of John, chapter 20, verse 20, as the Father has sent me, so I am also sending you. I and the Father will send the Holy Spirit to you. So there is that point or on mission. The Father sending the Son, the Father and the Son is sending the Holy Spirit. And we receive this during the feast of the Pentecost. So there is that dimension of mission telling us that mission, first of all, is a mission of God, that our God is a missionary God. Our God is a missionary God. That is why if the church is patterned after our God, then this church should also be a missionary church. So missionary for the church. So mission comes from God. Mission is God himself. So let's try to reflect on our scripture that we choose for tonight's reflection. And then from that, we get the implications of vision in our, the implications of this reading in our lives as missionary disciples. So, kita talk about missionary disciples. Now, if we go back to the passage that we read, though he was in the form of God, he did not deem equality with God. But emptied himself, taking on the nature of a servant made in human likeness. So there is here the dimension of mission, the Father sending the Son. Though he was in the form of God, but he emptied himself. Emptying is part of that dimension of becoming a missionary. Emptying for the sake of being one with our beloved. Emptying or denying ourselves to be with our loved ones. And that is what the Lord is telling us in this reading. He emptied himself. So the Father sending the Son, emptying himself. He did not deem equality with God. Out of humility, he humbled himself and emptied himself. Now to be with us. So there is that movement here. A movement of the Lord is a descending movement. Gikan sa taas, nanao to be with us. It's good to realize that as missionaries, to be with people whom the Lord has sent us to serve, importante kayong pagkanao uban sa ilahang, to be with them. A self-emptying. And this emptying is not just something, but the motive of self-emptying, you can say, Ginoo, is no other than because of His love for us. The ultimate motive of the Lord of emptying Himself to be with us is because of His great love for us. So, emptying. Then, that is why I think many of you or some of you might have done your pilgrimage in Bethlehem. And so Bethlehem, if you go down to the place where our Lord was born, doon ay namutana, ano magyod nga, gamay kayo ang pultahan. Daghang itaw. Pag-abot dito sa place, gamay kayo ang stair, manaog kapag kuniya, bubuk pagit ang pultahan. You have to bend in order to enter. So, itong one of our guides, he's also a priest. We had our, organized was a neo-catechumene, a group of bishops went there, and he explained why was that built that way. Na, you can sa dinhi, pag-abot sa lugar, manaog ka, gamay na lang, kunya pagsunod to gini mo, muduko, yun ka. That posture tells us of a God who emptied himself, who humbled himself, emptied himself to be with us. That is why, kung masunod ka dito, you have to humble yourself before the Lord. Muduko, yun ka. Hindi magkakasunod o magtiso. Muduko, yun. Kunya, pag-abot sa sunod, ang star man dito, star, labaw na yun ka mo, hapa na yun ka mo, kesa star. That gesture is also telling us that like our Lord Jesus Christ who humbled himself to be with us, we approach him with all humility, adoring the Christ Jesus. Kinahalan mo, duko puta. Importante siya kayong aspeto as missionary disciples. And then in the Gospels, after that gospel episode where it tells us of the finding of the Lord Jesus, where he grew in age, wisdom, and grace under the care of Saint Joseph and Saint Mary, Mama Mary. And by the way, we declare ba karon ni Pope Francis a year of Saint Joseph. So last December 8 until next year. So after that, wala na hilog na ang gospel unsa nahitabo kang sa atong Ginoo. Ang ibutang lang, he grew in age, wisdom, and grace. Nigawas siya during his public ministry at the age of 30. He was offered to the temple at the age of 12. So those years from age 12 to 30, silent ang gospel. Unsa kay implication na sa mission? Nothing has been discussed or revealed on those years. Gituwag mo na ito na sa hidden life of Jesus. The hidden life of Jesus. So, makita na ito nga implication na lang sa mission, that mission can also be done through anonymity. No? Anonymity. In fact, yesterday's gospel, katong nungutana ang mga tao, manong nagbunyag ka man. Pangutana nila si Juan kung magbubunyag. Niya nag-ingon si Juan magbubunyag na ay musunod ka na ko, who is among you, but you did not recognize. You did not recognize. He is among you, but you did not recognize. So one aspect of the missionary life of Jesus is anonymity. Ano wala siya, no? Hilog kayo ang gospel, ano? In fact, people will call him, he's the son of a carpenter. He's the son of Mary. He has brothers and sisters. But those years, the hidden life of Jesus is telling us that mission can be done through anonymity. And of course, the anonymity reminds me of the sharing of the mission of a certain priest, a Merinol priest in Bangladesh. There was that mission congress last year 2000 in Cebu, and he is one of the speakers. Their Father Robert Macahill, he was in Davao before, no? Tagum. Yeah, dito siya gipadala sa one of the towns in Bangladesh, Muslim tanan. He's the only Christian and Catholic in that village. So he's really anonymous. Di isa mailhan. What was he doing there? Simply, as priest, mag-ampo sa morning prayer, mag-ampo sa tanan, morning evening prayer, mag-misa siya, and then after sa mass, he went around the village. Ilan sa mga tao. Unya kay pobre po itong village, tabang siya sa ilang mga panginahanglan noon. Doon ay masakit, dadon niya sa hospital. So, kana ang iyang routine. So, after a while, people were asking, nga nung gihimo maninimo, kinsa man ka? Nga nung nagtabang magka sa amua? Nasahay, kita niya nga, nila nga gaampo siya. So, nakatana ang mga silingan, no? Na he became curious of what he was doing. So, later on, ipalailan niya, yung siya nga, I do this to you, or for you, because my brother told me to do it for you. So, ingon siya nga, nakatana siya, kesa man ay imong brother? His name is Jesus. His name is Jesus. So, asa man na si Jesus? So, he began to share about the life of our Lord Jesus Christ. And so, he began to realize that he is a Christian, and not only is a Catholic, but not only a Catholic, that he is a priest. But then, he became friends, though they invite niya sa mag-ampo tagdungan. So mag-ampo mo sa inyong Quran, mag-ampo ko sa scripture. Of course, madupaniya, they were really converted by heart. Converted by heart. Or lisod kayo mapabunyag dito ng lugar. You will be ostracized by the community. So by heart, they become Christians. But, ingon siya, just be faithful to your faith as a Muslim. And I will be faithful to my faith as a Christian. And we worship the same God. So, pero by heart, gusto nangit silang mabunyagan. So that's an example of anonymity in mission. Pwede di ay nanon. Dili na ito ipasiatap atong kaugalingon. Pwede rin di ay inana. By anonymity. Na ilhan po nasangyaw niya si Jesus. Of course, atong reading, Jesus remained obedient to the Father until death. His filial obedience to the Father, obeying the will of the Father until his death. But because of that sacrifice, he was also vindicated by the Father, and he was given the name above every other name. He was also vindicated. He was risen from the dead. So that the whole life of Jesus is a missionary life. And this life of Jesus is really giving us hope in our pilgrimage here on earth as missionary disciples. That at the end of our journey, he will be with us. We will be with him. We will be united with him more perfectly. The risen Lord. So that's the life of Jesus, no? From God, balik siya sa Amahan, fulfilling his plan of salvation. He was sent on a mission to proclaim the good news. So what are the implications of this missionary life of Jesus in our own lives today? We have mentioned already about anonymity, humility, and others. So first, what are the implications? That we can conclude from the summary of the life of Jesus, that first, mission is best served by powerlessness, not by conquest. It is best served by dialogue, by acknowledging the rays of truth in others. Mission is best served by powerlessness. Gusto magitag power, pero look at Jesus on the cross. Mission is best served by powerlessness, by the power of love. Not power, but it's the power of love. So it's no longer done through the power of conquering the others. 500 years ago, kana siguro ang nahitabo, no? Nag-uban ang sword and cross. But looking back to the scriptures, mission is best served through powerlessness, no longer by conquest. It is served by dialogue of life, being with others, being with us. That's why, though he was God, he did not deem equality with God, and out of humility, become one of us. Dialogue, to be with us. Incarnation, he took flesh. Dialogue. So mission is best served through powerlessness, not by conquest, but through dialogue. Acknowledging the rays of truth in others. So dili na katosiglan tagdebate ng bihagay pa, no? You have to respect each other. You have the ray of truth sa imuha. Then you have to respect sama kang father, Makahil. So dialogue, that was the year last year, no? Interreligious dialogue. And then, so mission is best served by powerlessness. Second, mission takes the form of servanthood. Servanthood. So, the letter of Paul to the Philippians said, we ought to follow the servant mind of Christ. The servant mind of Christ, he humbled himself to be with us. Servanthood. So, it's no longer, it's a movement from superiority to humility. Servanthood, there's a movement from superiority to humility. Basing on the power of the Word, the Holy Spirit, who is the principal agent of mission, and motivated by no other than love. Mission takes the form of servanthood, a movement from superiority to humility. Katong kaniadto, of course, ang mga Spanish consider themselves as superior before us. They are superior race. Mausap gyapon katong sa atong fiesta last December 12, Our Lady of Guadalupe. Si Mama Mary, nagpakita kang Juan Diego, who is a lumad in Mexico, and Mama Mary wore the dress of a lumad. What does that mean? That in God's plan, in God's love, we are all the same. We possess the same dignity as God's beloved children. So, the Spaniards are not superior over the Lumads in Mexico. So that is also, before, it's more superiority. I have the superior power, more powerful than you, so you are more inferior. But mission takes the form of servanthood. Manaog, magalagan, from superiority to humility. Basing on the Word of God and the Holy Spirit, which is the principal agent of mission. So what do I mean by the Holy Spirit as the principal agent of mission? As we said, during the Feast of Pentecost, when the apostles received the Holy Spirit, they began proclaiming the good news. They went outside and proclaimed the good news. So, mission is best served by powerlessness, not conquest. Mission takes the form of servanthood. Third, mission is to be in solidarity with victims, to listen to their dreams, hopes, and bear those dreams in our lives. And mission means to be in solidarity with people who serve. Jesus descended from the Father to be with us. And who are we? We are insignificant people. Insa magunta, anong nanao pamagod siya? We are all sinful people. We are not faithful to the covenant. And yet, it's all because of love that He becomes incarnate. Kunya na natao siya sa manger, another very insignificant place. Ano sa manger pumangin siya natao? At ugali mga bata, matao magita sa birthing clinics. Siya natao sa manger, very insignificant place. And He was born with us, among us, who are very insignificant people, to be in solidarity with us. He took flesh. Nahimo siyang unod sa manato, gawas lamang sa sala. You see how the magnitude, no? The magnitude of the love of God for us. Manong kinsamanta, no? This is also the point of Psalm 8. Who are we? Manong gibangga man ta pag-ayo sa Ginoo? Kung atong isipon, we do not deserve, but yet God becomes incarnate because He loves us so much. So, hindi tayo nga pamalanduman na siya in this Christmas season. Nga nung gipadala pa sa Ginoo ang iyang anak. We are insignificant persons. We are unfaithful to the covenant. And yet, He sent His Son to be with us. He took flesh. So mission means to in solidarity with the people we serve. To be in solidarity with the people, with your families, your neighbors, just as the Lord humbled Himself to be with us. So, walay pili na ba, no? Walay pili. Kinsa ka itong mga tao nga matanaw na ito, insignificant for us. Basig sila mo yung mga tao na rin gitawag kita sa Ginoo to be with them. Walay pili ba yan eh? It's all because of love. So mission is best served by powerlessness, servanthood, solidarity with victims, listening to their dreams and hopes. And fourth, mission also means silence and contemplation. To be in silence and contemplation. So we thought of mission is an active word, no? Kind of action. Mission good, action perli. But mission also means silence and contemplation. Dili di pwede nga sigil lang tang buhat, walay pag ampo, walay pag pamalandong. Silence and contemplation. Go back to the life of Jesus. There are always times that's spent with the Father alone, whether early in the morning or after His death. Doon na ginay siya panahon nga mag-inusara aron mag-ampo sa iyang amahan. No matter how busy the Lord was, He really spent time with the Father. The key word, one of the key words of his mission and ministry is the Father. He always spent time with the Father. Bisan ang iyang mga apostles who was sent on a mission, after that, they brought him to the desert to be silent, to contemplate. So there is the shift of mission, the understanding of mission, from activism to contemplation. So dili lang sige na tagtrabaho diri sa parokya, busy ka na adlaw, kung dili, doon nag-get time for contemplation, silence. So that's a constitutional dimension of mission, contemplation. From being in mission to doing mission. From being a missionary to doing mission. So, dili pwede bulagon ang pagka-missionero nato o ang pagbuhat sa mission. They have to go together. That is why we are called to be missionary disciples. We are called as missionary disciples. We remain a disciple and yet we are called on a mission. We are missionaries and yet we still remain as a disciple of Christ. We need to listen to the Lord. Spend time with God in silence. Yun ay isang theologian. Nagingon siya, what should be our best response to this pandemic? Our faith response to this pandemic? Nagingon siya, one of the best response, a faith response in this pandemic is contemplation. Contemplation. And he said, by contemplation, we immerse ourselves in the heart of God. we immerse ourselves in God's life. And by doing so, we can see this pandemic from the lens of God. It's like a movement is in constant, in contemplation. There is an ascending movement, learning to gaze at God, leading us to the descending movement of learning to how to gaze at the world with the eyes of God. So that's the point of contemplation. Kanabang tanaw nato ni siya sa mga mata sa pagtuo. Tanaw nato ni yung pandemic through that broader lens of God's eyes. Lahi din atong pananaw, no? Malahi atong pananaw. Otherwise, kung limited ka itong pananaw, base sigilan tao, kasuko. Ano sa mawala na yung face mask, dili makita atong smile. No? Sa mata, makikita ang atong smile. Ang tod kanus na panis siya. Apan, if we really immerse, and I believe in his point, if we immerse ourselves in God, then we can look at this situation from a broader perspective. We can only see what is the difficulties, but also we can also see the silver linings of this pandemic that has brought us in our lives. Doon na ba ako yung mga silver linings sa pandemic? For instance, during Holy Week, ang nakita dito, niyad ko kayo nga, nakita nga, it was highlighted, ang atong simbahan are closed, this one, but the churches in the home were open. We stay at home more often as a family. Home churches were open. At ako ba kayo na siya nga mensahe kung atong tagaan o bugat na pagtagaan, no? The first church, the domestic church, are our families. So basig nalimtan na ito na siya for a minute time, for a while. And with this pandemic, it was highlighted, the home churches. In fact, during the Holy Week, we were not allowed to participate here in the liturgy, but there are lots of home liturgies during that time. So doon ay mga angay na ito nga i-pick up with all this pandemic. Lessons that we can get because of this pandemic that can also be can change the way we live and our lifestyle. Of course, you want to know some conspiracy theories. There is one priest who is also an environmentalist, the Father Sean McDonough. He also said, you know, this pandemic is also calling us to really be sincere in our responsibility to care for our common home. If we destroy the natural habitat of these animals, that is why there is that movement from their natural habitat to the human beings. So unsa atong gibuhat kuno sa natural habitat sa mga unsa ni bat kalapanit. If we destroy their natural habitat, so it transferred to human beings. And if we keep on destroying their natural habitat, the more pandemic we will also experience. Hindut na kayo, I was still in Balay-Balay during that time. And this is our observation. Before the pandemic, every 5 o'clock, diya sa highway, diya magtugdon ang mga langgam, ang sayaw. Diya sa wire, electric wires. Diya magsuko ang mga tao, kaya siyempre, mangiti mo na. No? Maitihan ka, kung hindi ka magbantay, na, maitihan ka. Imong sakinan, ihan ko na. Gahe na ba kayo na mawala man sana niyang iti. Pero, during the lockdown, during the lockdown, nawala ang mga langgam, ang observation. So, yun may nga, pati dito langgam, gilockdown po. Pati langgam, gilockdown. O, nawala na. Hulatan na mo pagka May, eh, sugod naman itong balik ng mga tao, yung sakinan, pero wala na mabalik ang langgam. So, there's something there. No? Of course, di ba, katong nakita na itong observation sa Makati during that lockdown, you can see the blue, clear skies. Sa Venice, because of that lockdown, nanggawas ang mga dolphins dancing. Very playful. Di ba kakita o dolphins sa Venice kay motorboats diya halos kada adlaw ga biyahe. So nakapahulay ang kalibutan because of that lockdown, because of that pandemic. But we hope that kumabalik na ta sa normal, dili ta mabalik atong morag hapon nga pamahagi. There's something there. There's something there. That this also teaching us a lesson. That is why it's good to really, ingatong theologian, it's good to really bring this experience to God in prayer, silence and contemplation. Silence and contemplation. Looking at these events from the eyes of faith, from the eyes of God. Usahay kay makidugog ka sa atong mga igsuon na dunay third eye. Na madlok ba ta? Basta, uy, kana siya dunay third eye. Na madlok na ta. Kaya ang ilang makitaan, anak, ang sino makita ng mga third eye? Kanang dili ko no ingon nato. Third eye. Apan kita beta na dunay third eye. Gawas ka itong usalang mata. Pero kita, normally, duha man itong mata, kitang tanan dunay third eye. What do I mean by our third eyes? Our third eye is the eye of faith. Looking at this from the eyes of faith. So, dili katong third eye nga makakita o dili ingon nato. Katong third eye nga makakita sa mensahe sa Ginoo, diya sa mga pangitabo sa atong kinabuhi. Di ito mahadlok, anak. No? Mahala, na ako'y third eye. Kung wala ka third eye na, saan na ito pagtanaw? Niinis sa mata sa pag-tuo. So, that's the point there. No? So, that's the fourth implication there. Mission is served by servanthood, powerlessness. Mission takes the form of servanthood. Mission means to be in solidarity with others. Mission is best served in silence and contemplation. From being in mission to doing mission. From being a missionary to discipleship. And discipleship leading us to mission. Fifth, other implications of mission in our lives is mission is collaborative. It's no longer done by individuals. Kaniadto, like for instance, diya sa history sa evangelization sa Bukidnon, the missionaries were called or described as rugged missionaries. Suot-suot sa mga kasagutan, no? Rugged missionaries. Kung asa itong mga lumad, at tuon nila. Aron mga hinahinay mag-dialogue of life, then ma-introduce nila si Kristo, then they can form their Christian community. That's how they spent, or they did mission before. Na dili man pwede mag, wagadalan, disurg kayo. Kung nag-ingot sila rugged missionaries, they do it individually. No? Makita na ito, madugog na ito mga ngalan of individual missionaries. So, sa bukid no, na si Father Coley, the missionary of the South, sa Southern Bukid no, yung base marama, this week, ato siya sa Wao, baklay sa kahit kabayo, sunod semana, ato na po sa Damulog, Sir Smart, ito na po sa Buddha. Siya na yun, ha? Alone. Of course, na magkauban ng mga laigo. Pero sa atong panahon karon, when we talk about mission, there is that movement of from individualism to collaboration, team ministry. Ngani diya sa itong parokya, before, sa kakaraanan, pari betanan galihok dire, no? Pari center. Pero karon sa Vatican II Church, ang parokya should be a participative community. A communion in of communities. No? A communion of communities. A network of basic ecclesial communities. So, nung pahulagway na to sa parokya, no? Dili na siya pari center, but it should also be a participative community, collaborative community. Because mission, every one of us is called on a mission. Collaborative. By virtue of our baptism, we're all missionaries. So, kinahalan magtinabangan ka sa mission. O collaborative. So, sa itong mga BECs, Basic Ecclesial Communities, participation in the mission to become a priestly community, prophetic community, a serving community. So, it's all, the focus is now the community. Collaboration of each one of the members of the community. And that is mission. Mission is done not just individually, but now it's more of collaboration. Collaboration. Kini mo nang atong sinipidari sa atong parokya, no? Doon na yung collaboration. Not only in terms of projects. Doon yung projects, maglaro kayo ng collaboration. But not only about projects, but in terms of living out our call to be missionary disciples. Each one of us should help and collaborate to become missionary disciples of Christ. So we make use of the different gifts that the Lord has given us for the building up of the church, for the building up of the parish. So finally, another paradigm shift of mission. Mission is, I don't know how you consider it. Your mission as parents, for instance. Is it a burden or a privileged gift? So mission ba? Saka palasunon, is a burden? Or is it a privileged gift? Dito mo pa saan na ganita, bugatan ka, kabugat budani, no? Kung namangayin na itong mga anak ko pang Christian, bugat din ako, no? Deliver na sa yon. So, gift ba na siya? Gift ba na siya? Or burden? So, there is that movement, no? From considering mission as a burden to a privileged gift. Because as we said, God or Jesus calls us to share in His mission. We are not the ones who offer ourselves to be missionaries. He's the one who entrusted to us His mission. So it's really a privileged gift, no? Mission is not a sacrifice I offer to the Lord or we offer to God, because mission does not come from us. So mission, as we said, mission comes from God. Our God, who is a missionary God, giba, participate niya sa iyang mission. So privilege gift na siya. Gasa na di kan sa Ginoo. kana masakit na ta, di ba? Di ba? Kung na itong prayer, masakit na ta, i-offer na nga ito sa Ginoo. Morbid ridden. Ang tawag ni St. Paul, ana, by that time, we are called to share in the suffering of Christ for the salvation of the world. You see? Lahi nga pananaw. Of course, ang pag-shift, ana, kinalagi na grasya sa Ginoo. Kaya ang ato makita, palas anon magyad ni, bukat magyad ni. No? Kanang kanta bito ni Sharon Juanita, wala Juanita, pasan ko na ang daigdig, pasan ko na ang daigdig, pasan na akong kalibutan, walang problema, bukat na kayo, ako na ginapasan sa kalibutan, malimtan na to, panahon sa Santo Niño, ang kalibutan nasa kamot sa Santo Niño. Pero kung naasa ito ang problema, di madala. No? Mara kita na ginapasaan sa kalibutan, wala na sa Ginoo. Kung nabinaw ka ng sama karon sa pandemic, wala pa mag solusyon. Inoon na na may vaccine. No? There's some light at the end of the tunnel, pwede rin ang vaccine. Although, huwag na nilang papakuna, basta i-boost lang ko ng immune system, okay na. So, kana ba? Kana pang tanaw na to, is mission a burden or do we see it as a gift from the Lord? If we really see this mission as coming from God, then this is really a privileged gift. Ipaambit lang ta niya sa iyang mission. Nagusa, kung magka-problema sa panimalay, problema sa inyong kinabuhi, problema sa parokya, na yung mga may Ginoo, imo ba yung yung mission? Imo na kong ipadala din, hey, tagaay ko kusog, tagaay ko giya, na makalingkawas ani, kay imo ba ning mission? Igo na kong nag-ambit niya ani. So, ibalik ko sa iya. Igo na kong nag-ambit, this is a privileged gift from the Lord that we share in His mission. Because that's the way the Lord is dealing with us. Ano man nga kinahanglan pa magita, no? Pwede naman ta ito, nanaog sa gini, nahimong tao, ng sangyaw, ipang kwa na ta atong una-una, ipang inala, no? Maay na layan, pero dili man ta robot. It's also gifted us with free will. So, ginanan na kumbinsihon ito maayo. Sangyawan o maayo. Nagkitang ipaambit na ng mission. So, that's really a privilege. Privilege. It's not a burden. So, kung mabugatan na ta, munang prayer sa gospel, come to me, those who finds life burdensome. And I will give you rest. And I will give you rest. For life is not really a burden. Mission is not a burden, but it's a privileged gift from the Lord, who is first of all a missionary God, because mission comes from Him. It does not come from us. The shift, the paradigm shifts sa mission. So, to be truly a missionary disciple, we really need constant communication with our Lord who sent us on a mission. We have to continually ask the guidance of the Holy Spirit, the principal agent of mission, to inspire us, especially in times of difficulties. And finally, the goal of mission. Of course, the goal of mission, the universal plan of salvation, is to be in communion with our God. So, katong readings na to, at the end of the day, God the Father has vindicated the Son, giving Him the name above every other name. He was risen. He became victorious. Our goal as missionary is also to be in perfect communion with our loving God. this is a hopeful journey. A hopeful journey. So dili ni atong pilgrimage sa kalibutan is not doomed towards failures or darkness, but our pilgrimage on earth is a very hopeful journey. There's always a ray of hope, no? There's always a ray of hope in our lives and as we fulfill the mission entrusted by the Lord to us. So, atong prayer is that the Lord will continually send the Holy Spirit to guide us and enlighten us and to inspire us and to give us strength as we continue to proclaim the good news of salvation. Then, last thing, see Pope Francis, through the Congregation of the Clergy, I think 3 months ago, came out with a pastoral exhortation on the pastoral conversion of the parish community in the service of the evangelizing mission of the church. Pastoral conversion of the parish community in the service of the evangelizing mission of the church. In this year of mission, we are really reminded of our missionary task. Matupani Pope Francis, we hope that in our parishes, we do not just remain in the structures confining us in the parish, but we should also go out and give people something to eat. Give them something to eat. There are people who needs our help. Quoting from the gospel, when Jesus told the disciples or the apostles, give them something to eat. So we should not remain in the structures. We should not be confined in the structures of the parish. But as a parish community, we are called on a mission to give something, to give others something to eat. I don't materially, but spiritually, something that our people needs. Because in the peripheries, there are people who really needs our help. So we hope that with that, matagaan ta sa gracias sa Ginoo to become truly His missionary disciples. So I would just like to summarize. Mission is served by powerlessness, servanthood, solidarity with others, silence and contemplation, prayer, collaboration, and mission is not a burden but a gift from our missionary God. So thank you very much. We hope that those points can now empower you, though we do not have a PowerPoint. I hope that you can pick up some points there that can also empower for your reflection as missionary disciples of Christ. Daghang salamat ug maayong gabi kaninyong tanan.
Daghang salamat, Bishop, sa imong pagpaambit ug pagpalawom sa misyon. Maghangyo ta og duha lang nga mupaambit sa iyang kasinatian o naipangutana nga mahitungod sa gihisgutan karon ni Obispo. Lalaki o isa ka lalaki o isa ka babay. Kinsa man ang buot nga mupaambit o mangutana. Anybody? Wala na? Limitado ra ba itong oras? Wala na?
Paing gabi, I am Febs, Bishop. I would like to address this to you. I'm curious lang ko, Bishop, ba, like we're talking about mission, and then on your part, kanusaan nimo na feel nga mao ni ang mission nimo, and then how did you respond to it? Kay mao ni pud ang sa amo sa ibitaw, like sa bani mission baka ni or ako ra ni huna-huna. So please enlighten us. Thank you.
So mission really is a fruit of our prayer and contemplation, di ba? That's why this one dimension, there is silence and contemplation. Then we have to bring this to prayer. That situation that calls for our help. Of course, as a fruit of our prayer, part of our discernment, discerning in contemplation. Through our discernment, we can say that this is really the call from the Lord. Makita mo na to, we feel at peace with God, at peace with what we are doing. So that's one fruit, no? The fruit of the Spirit. There is joy in doing and fulfilling this. There is love because you do this out of love. Dili wala ni function. Mission is not just a function. It's really powerlessness, the power of love. And if you do it that way, dunay joy diya nga dili mo ma-bayran of any material things in the world.
Salamat, Bishop. Napay isa lang, isa kalalaki. Kinsa man. Wala na? Wala na isa kalalaki nga mo paambit o mangutana.
So may gabi kaninyo, so regarding sa missions, kwan po kayo na, nindot ko ito yung gingon ni Bishop nga missions is to give, sa ito yung gana, ang missions, ito yung nga ihatag ang tanan. Sa ako, mang good father, Bishop, usa mo ko ka defensors of Catholic, gitawag ni siya o Catholic faith defenders. So, katong gayon gay na, tong sa Divisoria, is may tong sige o defensa dira sa Divisoria. So, ang akong pangutana lang kang Bishop is kami munggod dira sa Divisoria is kwanjud ka ng midzo. Ang amo ang pagpamagi is to proclaim the truth sa atuang simbahan. Then namanggoy kasagara nga dunay mga masuko, especially sa mga especially sa uban nga relihiyon nga masuko sila. Then sometimes ang among kauban is mo sukol pud sa ila ang pagkasuko. So medyo mag-away. So unsa may mas angay buhaton sa amo nga side sa isip nga Catholic faith defender aron malikayan namo ang gubot. Daghang salamat.
Okay, daghang salamat, no? Mas marke dunay CFD. So ginay gitawag ni sila apologetics, no? Kay depensa sa atong faith. But ang main purpose for apologetics, for the ongoing formation sa ato ang mga Katoliko. Bukid ito ang main purpose. Ay, sa high ang catechism, after sa elementary, those who, wala na yung catechism. So, katabang ang atong CFD. And also, Ikaduha nga makatabang sa ato ang mga Catholics is ato mga uban ng mga sekta is still very aggressive on proselytizing. No, atuon ka, dagabasahan ko mga versikulo, versikulo against Mary, versikulo against the saints. So, kitang wakitahan daw sa mga versikulo, dalit tama, dala, madala, labi na sa mga universities, mga youth, no? So, munang nakatabang na ang CFD, para sa lahat, they will also learn about the scripture, no? Not just to defend, but really, ang laong pangakuan sa CFD is really to learn the scripture. So that's why ang CFD should always be connected sa Bible apostolate. Bible apostolate. Aron sige, dili malikay na ito sa yung siging debate. No? Dili na pang debate ng bang bihagay sa una. No? Dili, first of all, primarily for our Catholics to also learn and to also know how to know our the doctrines of our church and especially with the scripture. So tie up ko na siya sa Bible apostolate.
Sa ngalan sa Sanctuario Eucharistico o sa tanang mga parokyano sa atong Cora Paroko o sa atong mga kaparian dinhi o sa ato ang superior sa SSS, dako kaya nga itong pagpasalamat ng obispo na may kahin siyang panahon niining niya higayuna. Ato siyang pasalamatan at pinaagi sa ato ang masipang apakpak. O karon atong hangiyoon si Father Ixor Ibalie, ang atong superior sa SSS, o si Mrs. Lolita Bolson. Aron sa paghatag sa kang sa token kang obispo. Gihangyo nato si obispo. Diri sa tunga.
So, una sa tanan, daghang salamat sa inyong pagtambong sa oras ng inyong gigahin. Personally, Bishop, ako nagapasalamat sa imong pagpalalong sa tawag sa Diyos sa matag sa kanamo. Nga ang misyon sa gingkaingon ni Bishop, ang misyon din lang sa mga kaparian, sa kabadrihan, kay Bishop, kundili sa atong tanan. So diha sa imong pagpalalong, Bishop, sa among responsibility as Christians, maninguha usab ako, maningkamot usab ako, isip usaka alagad sa Dios, isip usaka pari, na diha sa imong pagpalalong sa among misyon, mapalalong usab nako ang akong commitment bilang isang pari, bilang isang ordained priest. So in behalf of our parish priest, Father Kenny, and our parishioners, we have this little or small token for you as an appreciation for your time, your wisdom, and everything, Bishop. So thank you so much.
May gabi, Bishop. Salamat kayo sa imong mabulukon o maonoron nga paghatag kanamo karon sa among recollection. Now, allow me nga magbasa Sanctuario Eucharistico, Sacred Heart Parish, Archdiocese of Cagayan de Oro, preserve the certificate of appreciation to Archbishop Jose Aranita Cabantan, D.D., in grateful appreciation and acknowledgement for having shared with the faithful his knowledge, belief, and faith as the resource speaker of the Parish Advent Recollection, given this 14th day of December in the year of our Lord 2020 at Santuario Eucaristico, Sacred Heart Parish, Rodolfo in Palais Boulevard, Causwagan, Cagayan de Oro City. Signed by our parish priest, Reverend Father Kenny Joe Parlingayan, SSS, and our PPC president, but wala man amo presidente, so I have to sign for Lolita Buzon, and our president Morana Ababo. Salamat kayo, Bishop. Salamat again, Bishop.
O atong hangyoon si Obispo alang sa final blessing.
Ang Ginoo, mana ka ni Diyo. Ugang panalangin sa makagagahong mga Diyos, ang Amahan, ang Anak, ugang Espiritu Santo, mukunsad ka ninyo, ug magpabilin diya ka ninyo, hangtod sa kahangturan. Maayong gabi sa tanan.
Yeah. Recollection. Totally lost, we never saw.